to the Haverhill Journal, where we give you a quick look at what's going on in our city. I'm Lindsay Paris, and this week, as you can see, we have stepped out of the studio and we are celebrating the heart of summer with an episode all about the greatest amusement parks in the Merrimack Valley, past and present. And when we're talking about amusement parks, where else could we start but the beautiful Canobie Lake Park here in Salem, New Hampshire.
One of New England's favorite theme parks, Canobie Lake has been delighting folks from near and far for over 100 years.
First, I'd like to welcome you to Canobie Lake Park, sitting right here in Salem, New Hampshire. Over 85 rides, games, shows, and attractions. We've actually been here since 1902, so we are over 100 years old. We actually started as a trolley park. So back when, in the early 1900s, when people didn't have automobiles in their driveway, people would ride the trolleys back and forth to work Monday through Friday. But the trolley companies needed an excuse for people to come and ride on the weekend, so they would make these small pleasure resorts, usually sitting on a lake where they'd be canoeing and things like that, all throughout the United States.
There are three coasters here at Canobie Lake, but everybody's favorite is the Yankee Cannonball, which has been here for 79 years and is one of the only wooden roller coasters left in New England. As you can see, a lot of people behind me having a great time.
The Yankee Cannonball roller coaster also has quite a storied past. It was actually built in 1932, not for this amusement park. It was for another amusement park in Connecticut, and then was completely deconstructed in 1936 and moved up here to Salem, New Hampshire. The nostalgia of the Yankee Cannonball, whether you're riding it on your eighth grade class field trip for the first time, but your parents rode it on their eighth grade class trip, has a lot of history in that attraction.
Built in the 1800s, the antique carousel behind me is the oldest attraction at Canobie Lake Park and one of only 14 permanent carousels in all of New England. The music is supplied by a Wurlitzer organ from 1917, and some of the music rolls that are being played on it are from 1902.
The antique carousel was one of the very first attractions here at Canobie Lake Park back in 1902 on the day that we opened in August. It's still one of the only carousels left that's operated by a rubber tire, so we're very proud of that history. We have an original Wurlitzer organ in that attraction that we still maintain all the way to this day. That organ music is exactly what all of our guests hear, even in 2015 when guests are walking through our front gates.
The park sees a staggering annual attendance of over 50,000 visitors each year.
We're proud here at Canobie Lake Park to have that generational attendance where people are coming to show their kids what they were able to experience. We're also pushing into the future to be able to gain new attractions. We've added a water area, we've added a drop tower, swing rides, we've added a new roller coaster in 2011 called Untamed.
So I'm here acting as cameraman today, but I figured I'd take a little moment to share with you my favorite ride at Canobie Lake, the Extreme Frisbee. And it looks like it's on maintenance today, unfortunately, because I rode it way too many times. But I have frequented this park as a kid, growing up, as many of you have. And there's many, many rides, and they're always adding new rides. This just happens to be one of my favorites.
What's your favorite ride?
My favorite ride here, I have so many of them. I would say the Yankee Cannonball roller coaster. It's just such a staple. I remember riding it as a kid. I remember riding it yesterday. I may have ridden it this morning, and every year it just seems to get better and better.
One of the best parts of coming here to Canobie Lake, soaring 250 feet up in the air here on the giant sky wheel.
A lot of parks that used to be in our area may not even exist anymore. So we're one of the few in New England, and few and proud in New England, whether it's introducing the park to your young family members for the first time or just coming back and having a blast. That's what we're here for.